The Bleach anime is just simply doomed. From the PV, still frames, it is behind schedule, and it is very apparent, as some would actually like to say. So, today's video, I have my friend Roe, who is going to be talking with us today about what Taguchi means by Studio Pierrot being behind schedule. Would you like to say hello?
Hey guys, so looking forward to having a conversation with James about this stuff.
So if you haven't seen one of the recent anime expos, because you wouldn't, because Viz won't let you see it, in this video you will see that Taguchi, one of the directors for Bleach, is explaining the fact that, in a joking way, would you say?
Yeah, it was started off as a joke and then explained further.
Maybe, you know, yeah. Going from what I would like to believe from seeing the facial reactions and the conversation between the two directors, seems to be that, yes, there is a bit of truth behind the fact that they are, in fact, behind schedule, and it doesn't seem that they're too worried about it. Is that the kind of vibe that you got from it?
Yeah, as they said during the video, they feel like they're falling behind for a good reason, and that reason being...
Well, that's the question, isn't it? That is the question. Some might consider that it is due to Kubo's or Kudos's character designs. It's possible. I mean, I wouldn't lay it out there, but I generally think, going from my perception, is that they just generally... Maybe Taguchi is just a perfectionist and wants to bring out the best product that he possibly can. Because that's also maybe the context that we didn't get because of, you know, people blocking the screen, so I can't see. But I do believe that Taguchi might actually be a bit of a perfectionist, and is possible that he just wants to put out a good product. So I kind of respect him in that regard. So throughout the video at Anime Expo, you know, we get a little bit of a tour of Studio Pierrot. We see people working hard. We see, you know, someone cooking something in the corner. What is he cooking, you know? Yeah, like the fact that I think Taguchi is being so open about, you know, that, hey, they might be behind schedule, and he's showing us that people are working. You know, I think, and the fact that he's laughing about it too, and everyone seems very optimistic. I believe, if you remember correctly from the video, Roe, that we're kind of, you know, making sure to hit the nail on the head that the staff are very motivated and they are very excited as well to put out such a product.
Yeah.
And I believe one of the series compositioners, as well as Taguchi, was also saying that, you know, it is a very nerve-wracking situation to be working on such a big title as well. So I think, you know, I think every animator that is working on this, especially even the directors themselves, the people in a higher position, very well aware of the impact, not only, you know, worldwide, but also for their own name and image, for this series to do well. And I think that's why it's nerve-wracking for them, because they kind of know the importance of, not only for the fans, but also for them as well, maybe even for the studio itself as well. But that's just my interpretation. Would you agree with that, or do you have a different perspective?
I definitely agree with that. I feel like Bleach is a series that a lot of people have a long history with, either as a fan or as a veteran of a series, and I feel like they're gonna do their best to live up to that expectation. And as you said, a lot of the people in that industry are perfectionists as well, so they're gonna be working till they're sweating.
Hopefully not on that MAPPA type of work, but yeah. What we can do in this instance is, instead of overthinking about whether Bleach is doomed or not, or whether we're going to get a lackluster product, which I don't really believe, there's also been the question, which I think we should get out the woodwork as well, of whether this is going to be long running or split core. Now, you know, in terms of, we can only speak about leaks, we can only speak about sources. So again, you have to take about face value of what I'm about to say. But there was a time where it was talked about 4 core, which makes sense, because if you're going to do about 4 chapters an episode, then, you know, you do the math and it's about a year's worth of material. So it's guaranteed, even as a placeholder, that it's going to be at least a year's worth of content. And that's fine, because these things change all the time, such as Black Clover kept getting renewed as one of those examples. So, you know, it's just, it's a guaranteed right there if you were just going to commit to it on a one-to-one manga chapter scale. However, considering the new information that we've gone to, and I believe you were talking to me about this as well, about how you felt about it, some animators and even some people from the outside are kind of saying, actually, this might be split core and it might be the right decision. What are your thoughts on that? Do you think that that is the right decision, and do you think it's even possible, considering they haven't really given us a date, nor have they officially given us how many cores it's been?
The reason I was saying that, more so that not that it is split core, but that I hope it will be, is because they're saying that they're falling behind schedule. And to be honest, that's kind of to be expected as well. And especially in a long-running series, you're going to fall more and more behind schedule as the series goes on. Therefore, I believe that if they try to go the entire year straight, pushing out episode week after week, eventually it's going to catch up to them. So I hope that it at least splits after, let's say, after episode 25, right? So they have more time to catch up and work on the last half of the arc.
Yeah, and honestly, I'm more for quality over quantity. I mean, there's many opportunities for advertisement in between those split cores as well, in between that gap. I believe that it should be the case. Again, I'm not impatient. I want a good product, and I generally do hope that that is, in fact, the case, because we don't want to run, you know, the team down to the ground. So, along with the hearsays and what we can expect and what we've heard in the Doom post, and I think what's important is, let's have a look at the staff, right? We have arguably, and this is one of the reasons why I brought Roe onto today's video, is that there is some staff that, like, he cannot express enough of how great some of the staff, or how legendary some of the staff that we have on this team. That makes, you know, that worry, to take that little bit of a worry out of our systems. I think we should start with the chief animation directors. If you guys don't know, often these directors are ones that are really focused more on consistency of character designs. More so, would you say that's correct?
Yeah, so in the case of animation directors, in some series you have a one chief animation director, which is focusing on making sure that all the characters and the movements are on model with the character designs. In some cases you have the character designer be the chief animation director, but in this case they've chosen to actually have three chief animation directors. And that would make sense considering it's going to be a lot of episodes and there's going to be a lot of fighting and a lot of characters being involved in all the fights.
And it also seems the fact that they're doing multiple episodes in like bulk as well, so it's not like they're working on one or two episodes at a time. It seems like they're doing like multiple different episodes or multiple key moments and then building episodes around them. It seems to me anyway, but I could be wrong.
And the way they could be doing it with having three chief animation directors is that they could be doing like rotations of work where several episodes report to one chief and some others report to the other. So that's like, they could do a lot of different stuff with a production decision like that.
So we have three chief animation directors. That's Takayana guy, we have Hasegawa, and we have Kometsubara. And these, if you guys look, if you know, you can go on the Bleach website and you can see these names specifically. Every one of these guys' portfolios, there is not one, you know, red flag of a series. They've got massive experience. They've got a lot of work under their belt, so you can actually go see their previous work. And there's not one show on any of these guys' records that really give me any kind of worries. And honestly, like, the shows that they're working on, they're not, like, no-name shows. These are big, heavy-hitter shows, which have been renowned for praise in regards to its animation as well.
Yeah, and a lot of the staff in general here have followed Taguchi over from Akudama Drive, and a lot of the projects they're involved in, they've been involved in together as well. So I feel like this is a core staff that knows each other well and can work well together.
Absolutely. I mean, we've got a reoccurrence of people from MAPPA, people from WIT. We've got some reoccurrence of people that worked on like Shaft, for example, even old Bleach staff, which we know that old Bleach staff was going to work on it. But, you know, we've got people from Nisei Monogatari, for example, which is renowned to be such a greatly animated show. We've got people from Attack on Titan, which is quite, obviously, if you've watched Attack on Titan, It's renowned for its quality. We got the Persona and the Danganronpa franchise, which you can probably speak on a little bit about that.
Yeah, and I feel like Bleach is a series that is so flashy in its design, just the way they do the lettering and the color work, and even like just from Kubo's colorings and his clothes design and all that. It's very, very flashy, and I feel like some of the people they've gotten, like Saori Goda on the color design, and people that have worked on Persona and such, which has this like prominent, very stylized look, I feel like they're perfect for a Bleach anime.
I think as well, we're talking about like the amount of number of animation directors and chief animation directors. You know, the more you have, usually can be the more problematic problematic things can be. But I want to make it known as well that we have three on each side, and it's possible that one for each side is strictly on effects. So you have someone really correcting the effects or making sure the effects are on model, while you have two art, well, in this case, chief animation directors, which focus on art, and then two on the animation of motion, again, which we've spoke about, which makes sense because obviously one can work on one episode and the other can work on the other. Or you have one person on each team that is working strictly on the effects itself. So considering that this is a very flashy anime, I think it makes sense to have three rather than be safe two.
On this as well, which is really interesting, is that they have three chief animation directors, but they also have three action and effects animation directors. It becomes its own whole, like, a separate division or so that focuses on separate things.
And we have some great names for the animation directors. Now, if you guys don't know, just like with the chief animation directors, which I just gave you a brief rundown, the animation directors are focusing on motion, while chief animation directors focus on more so the consistency of how it looks, like in terms of art and character designs. Animation direction focuses on motion. And that's what we want, guys. We're going to have a lot of battles in the Thousand Year Blood War arc, and it is important that we get some beautiful looking scenes, right?
So first up, we have Satoshi Sakai, which is a legend within effects animation. Think of explosions, think of fire, think of special attacks, you name it. Sakai has a lot of experience in doing great animation effects work. He's also a very good animator, but Sakai over last many years have done some of the coolest effects animation in the industry. So having him on a series like Bleach, where you have all these different, like, imagine like the Bankai, imagine like Getsuga Tensho, all these kinds of things.
I mean, look at Attack on Titan, for example, like the smoke effects, the particles that we got, you know, all of the Attack on Titans, the electricity of when the Titans transform, you know, those are really good effects. And then you have Fire Force as well, which Fire Force effects have looked fantastic. How could I forget? One Piece film Gold looked amazing, especially with all those, like, if you want to talk about flashiness of, like, Bleach, film Gold was really flashy. Like, shiny, not flashy, shiny is more of the term. So again, like, that's really good when we talk about effects. So if you want to have a good idea of what Bleach is going to really be looking like, I guess One Piece Film Gold is maybe the best example of that.
Satoshi Sakai also did some stellar work on the Spy Family opening. Really cool, like, effects in that. I believe at the beginning of the opening, you have, like, this explosion and water effects and smoke and all that. I believe that was Sakai's work, and it looks really good.
Oh, how could I forget as well, Sword Art Online?
Speaking of Sword Art Online...
Oh, are you going to bring him up?
Oh, yes. I wanted to bring up...
the Mad Lad himself?
Yes, Yoshihiro Kano, which is quite a monster. I'm thinking, like, here we have Bleach, which has all of these fights, right? And Kano is one of the most effective and talented action animators, or rather ADs, in the industry. I've heard stories of where he has redrawn entire episodes of fights in Sword Art Online to make sure everything is on par with the quality they're aiming for, in terms of, like, having it on model or having it look good and flashy and the movement being great. So Kano is probably one of the greatest picks for the Bleach anime possible.
I cannot wait to see what cuts he does. I cannot wait to see what it's involved with. Like, his resume is just insane. You know, you got, not the original, but the 2011 Hunter x Hunter, for example. Naruto the Last Movie looks great. You have, again, all of the Sword Art Online, Ushura and Tora, which was a great Madhouse series. Parasite the Maxim was beautiful in and of itself. The Persona franchise, he has just worked. Gangster was great too. I mean, rest in peace to Megalobe. I think it was Megalobe? Megalobe, doesn't matter. And of course, his battle scenes within the Dragon Ball Z Battle of Gods movie as well. So I've got nothing but excitement to see what he can pull through the series. The last but not least as well is Yong Han Jung, which I hope I said that right. The portfolio is not as big as the rest of the staff that we have presented, but again, he's worked on Bleach in the past, which is fantastic. You want to keep that because, you know, someone who's you know, been accustomed to the art style and accustomed to how things have been. It's great. Worked on the Fate series and worked on, again, Sword Art Online. A lot of Sword Art Online members involved. And again, Nisei Monogatari, great as well. I do want to also say as well, and again, like, I don't really have much on the guard. I wish I could show you some footage on screen, but I just wanted to make it apparent that, you know, we have got some old Bleach stuff, which is good because, you know, they're familiar with the work. But I also wanted to say that Satoshi Sakai also did work on Bleach as well, and that hopefully there's some footage on screen for you right now of just his fire effects as well as his dust effects as well. So it will still feel, I believe, too, unless, like, the whole thing's changed. But everyone, every animator has his, like, own style. You are going to feel, I would like to believe you are going to feel nostalgic in the old anime, which I feel is important because I feel like the latest PV, and I don't know if you want to agree with me on this, but for me personally, before I do the breakdown of that PV on another video, so make sure to subscribe, it feels like it will alienate people from the old anime. And hopefully when the series comes out, we will see glimpses of, like, old style in there, molded in with the more modern technology. Is Bleach doomed, Roe? Is it something to be worried about? Is being behind schedule the end all be all? Is it in the bin before it's even come out?
Absolutely not. And I feel like the way we talk now about the staff breakdown and what kind of people they've got and what kind of system they seem to have in place with having three chief animation directors and having action and effects animators right there in the core staff with tons of talent and a lot of experience, I feel like that is what was needed to keep this anime up to the quality standards we expect from Bleach, right? I believe that it falling behind schedule doesn't necessarily have to be a bad thing, because they could just be rushing it out and, like, try to keep pace with, like, always being ahead of schedule. But that would probably be bad for the quality as well if they just, like, settled with being average, but instead they're striving for greatness.
So I guess the next topic of discussion would be in the future of will Bleach be split core, and that is something I'm specifically going to be looking out for because I think it's needed and I hope it is the direction that they go.
One thing though, I just noticed that Satoshi Sakai did key animation on Burn the Witch as well, which is pretty cool.
Really?
Yeah, I'm curious what it is. It's on episode 2, so
I'm pretty sure we'll show that on screen.
Yeah, I'll have a look out for it. But yeah.
Thank you so much again, Roe, for joining me on this venture of doom posting the Bleach fans. Hopefully, we've covered anything you guys may be worrying about with that comment. So, that being said, we're going to catch you guys later. If you want to see more videos with us, of course, like and subscribe as per usual. And as always, people, peace out.